In the big bill stack, we'll keep you in the know. In the big bill stack, we'll fix your techie woes.
And we'll break the tumble, make things till we're all together raking. And we'll
raise a cup of grog down in the big bill stack. In the big bill stack, come and join our fire crew. In the big bill stack,
we will show you what to do.
And we'll hack it till we crack it.
And we'll tell the world about it and forget to tidy up.
That's why it's now a bilge tank.
Hello and welcome to Bill Shank 056. I'm joined by Sandy McDonald and Paul Beach.
Hey.
We're going to talk about all the shiny things that make your Pi portable and usable and turn it into a kind of computer thing. So we've got
more integrated solutions. But first, Sandy's going to talk Moat.
Oh yeah, yeah. Yes. We can't not talk about Moat.
So we've got a new Moat tutorial that just came out at the beginning of the week about how to get started with Moat. So basically taking you through everything you need to know to be able to do stuff with Moat. So Moat is our...
Is that on the learning portal?
That's on the learning portal.
So learn.pimeroni.com.
Yeah.
There we do.
Brings it up on
let's get the tutorial.
There we go.
There's things in the way of things and stuff in the way of stuff.
Can we get the mini main camera?
Mini main camera. We may do that,
Yeah, so Moat is... basically a small driver board with four ports in it to which you can connect these LED strips. They are fully controllable RGB LEDs, 16 on each strip. They're APA 102 pixels, which are slightly different to the WS2812 or Neo pixels that you might be familiar with. And are kind of ubiquitous.
So you can kind of mount these inside your PC case,
yep.
In your Kallax furniture,
yep.
And they plug in via USB, and yep. You can control them by, you know, USB serial,
yep.
Basically.
Yep.
So them commands like red.
Yeah,
I'm
so
still,
not quite
I'm
like
still
that.
Scrolling.
So they work on Mac, PC, Linux,
yeah.
Whatever operating system you want.
Most things with a USB port that can drive APA 102s.
Yeah.
Well, no, serial.
Yeah.
You don't even
yeah.
need
yeah.
to know
serial.
About the APA
102s. No,
no. That's the point.
So you're basically just sending serial commands to the controller board.
Over your little blue stripe cable there, which is USB.
Nice.
And then out the other side, Moat cables.
So the tutorial tells you how to install the software library, and it's got instructions for... Linux, Windows and Mac. It tells you about how to light pixels on the strips, how to do basic animations, and then how to use Moat with cheer lights, which is a kind of crowdsourced light thing. So basically you can tweet a colour to cheer lights, and everyone in the world's lights that are connected up to cheer lights will turn to that colour. So that's quite nice.
Sweet.
Social lighting.
So learn.pimeroni.com.
Yep. There's also a tutorial that went up a couple of weeks back about how to control Moat with your iPhone. And in iOS 10, Apple have just released a new HomeKit app of their own. So before, you'd have to get a third-party HomeKit app. Now Apple have released their own app.
Sweet.
As they often do. So I've tested it with Moat and it works really well. Can we go to the close up?
Nice ideas, do I know I've worked that into our own software.
So here I've got the Moat sticks, just in a little diffuser case thing that I made. And I've got my iPhone with the Home app. And if I tap on the Moat, my laptop's going to sleep. if I wake my laptop up again.
You don't
want
to do that.
Yeah.
Here we go. And
nice.
Then tap
hey.
On that. Then
that was instant.
The lights come on. Yeah, yeah, it's really really responsive. So
obviously we're going to make
tap.
This work with Alexa
on.
When it comes out.
Yeah. And also this week, we've just got an Android phone. So to appease the Android fans out there, so I'm going to get this working with Android as well. It's quite a nice phone actually. It costs about
what's Google's home automation thing?
they don't seem to have properly released it yet.
It had one name and now it's got another, hasn't
it's
it?
Called Project Brillo, I believe.
That's unfortunate.
As Brillo. In Brillo pads.
Yeah.
There is, I believe the best way to do it is with an app called Tasker, which essentially allows you to do kind of like automation type things on Android.
Okay.
And there's another app that goes along with Tasker called AutoVoice. That hooks into OK Google.
Yep.
So you can then say, OK Google, switch Moto on.
So you need two apps for this.
Right.
I like my walls.
So you can then get OK Google to say, Siri, turn the lights on.
If you want to get really meta.
Yeah, and it can be like a scene in an airplane where, you know, the tunnelling announcers are passive aggressively. Yeah,
so I've now got...
it basically looks like every other phone.
Yeah, I've now got a kind of...
rectangle.
It's fairly nice actually. It's called the Wiley Fox. It runs Cyanogen, and I think it was about £120 on Amazon.
So it's the cheapest non-terrible phone.
Yeah, it's quite nice actually.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. Cool. Right, on to the roundup.
One other thing, we're going to be bringing out some other flavours of Motestick. one of them is going to be with white pixels, so just like all white. The other one is alternate white pixels and coloured pixels, which should be able to give you nice pastel shades.
Yeah, so this is kind of getting around the whole RGBW thing.
Yeah. Or you could switch between white and coloured if you wanted to.
Yeah.
One for utility lighting, one for kind of mood lighting.
Yep.
Sweet. Yeah. So we'll abstract that away so it's easy to do funky things with it.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds good.
Yep. So that's that.
Yeah. Right, so what we have here is we have
all the things.
Four different kind of integrated ways to have your complete Pi set up. And they all kind of do different things and have different focuses. So we're going to kind of go through them and look at some of the best features of them. And the next dock especially here, which is the white one, Phil, you described it best. How do you describe this?
I totally don't know what you're getting at.
No, you said it's like a laptop with the lightest parts.
Yeah,
taken
this
out.
Is this was Nico's words, I think.
Okay.
So I'm stealing someone else's quote.
Yeah,
that,
it's yours.
Yeah, it's basically a laptop with the lightest parts.
It's
quite heavy. But we found the original casing for this laptop. We found a laptop on AliExpress that looks identical to this in every way, but is an ARM laptop. So the casing is
Atom. Core Atom.
Is it a Core Core Atom?
Atom Celeron type thing.
Yeah,
and they actually say
I doubt that claim very much.
No, it looks legit. On the AliExpress page they tell you like for $35 you can have your own badge on it and things.
Yeah, your own startup screen.
That's what I got
for
you one if you want to. And the whole thing is about $200.
Yeah, it's
from China.
So they've done a very good job by taking an existing case and just retooling it and using it to create a new product, which means they don't have to go through any of the pain of injection molding. And not only have they used and populated every single port that's available on the laptop, including the camera and the microphones, but you can use all that stuff too. But we're kind of getting ahead of ourselves.
Yeah.
We should probably start with a bit of history on the Atrix laptop.
Yeah. Over here we have got a stack of boxes.
The thing that kind of kicked it off, really.
Oops. Early on, right, we had this.
I saw that coming. Yeah, so this...
Motorola had a phone called the Atrix, and if you look at, let's get the back of it on close up.
The future of computing.
Yeah. So get on the close up over there. What it was, you were supposed to take your Motorola phone.
Where is the close up aimed?
And you were supposed to drop it. You were supposed to drop it on the back of here, and it would turn into a laptop.
Cheers.
This is going back, you know, 4 or 5 years now. This was very early in the Pi days. Anyway, they overpriced this. And so they ended up selling off job lots of them, probably about 50,000 or more, for a pittance. And I think they were going as low as like 40, 50 quid early on, down from about 400. And so somebody in the Pi community kind of went, hang on, that's just a couple of adapter cables.
Let's make this happen.
It pretty much worked, and it's been kind of a staple of workshops ever since.
It's a really nice solution for the portable Pi problem. The trouble is the lap dock is a little bit special in some cases. For starters, the keyboard is terrible. It's utterly terrible. It's awful.
And Hebrew.
And it's Hebrew, which means that
Hebrew inside.
Even the most simple of extended characters for doing,
kind of complicated and uncommon stuff on the Pi, like programming or using Bash, then you are basically stuck. And a few people, like we saw people at, what was it, PyCademy, actually using these, and they had, they'd figured out where everything was through a long and arduous process of trial and error. And then I'd lean over their shoulder and go, and it was like a total muppet.
And it had some power saving quirks and things, didn't it?
Yeah, it's really, it's nice. It looks nice, and it probably kind of worked reasonably okay back in the day. But it's, as a product, it was a bit of a non-starter.
But for anywhere between kind of 50 and 80 quid, you could have essentially the progenitor of things like the NextDoc.
But yeah,
is that the right word? I use that word. It's a big word.
It's the one that has made everyone in the community kind of see this as a potential and rave about the idea of having a way of turning your Pi into a laptop and toting it around.
Yeah.
This is the... Shall we try and open it, in fact?
Let's see how the experience was.
The experience back in the day, because this is still sealed. Packaging. It hasn't even been opened. Gene found this on a shelf somewhere at the drop of a hat, which was super awesome. Sandy.
Well, we used them for some test checks.
Might open there.
You need to open those first, I'm sure. I thought you'd have your knife. You always have your knife.
Do you.
Knife off.
Knife off.
Quick.
One each, please don't kill me.
Oh,
we've got the
edge.
No one can see because the window's in the way.
It's a tie.
Get rid of the close-up.
Yeah.
Let's do this on...
Are you ready?
Big cam.
It's an empty box.
Excellent. That's a really nice out of the box experience, guys.
That was very Pulp Fiction.
Wait.
To pull.
You want to pull a tab or hold it? That's nice. Now we're talking.
Yeah.
Oh, swish.
Super
got
swish.
Got embossing here, so some nice touches. Yeah.
Power cable.
Power brick. Which we'll come on to later.
Slightly dangerous.
This one's good. Motorola, they know what they're doing.
Okay.
Motorola.
There we go. It's quite nice. It feels really nice.
It's a good finish.
It's definitely massively over-engineered. It's better built than most cheap laptops. I've definitely had laptops that felt worse than that. And it's got this nice little brushed aluminium effect, even though it's probably not aluminium. Never is.
Right, okay, so when you guys said Hebrew, I was imagining like only Hebrew letters on keys. I was going to say that'd be a nightmare.
Thank God it has the English alphabet on it, at least in part.
Yeah, it has Hebrew characters and normal
English characters.
Horrible. Yeah.
So it's a normal QWERTY keyboard.
You haven't really had to suffer one of these yet, have you? This is new to you. But yeah, it's actually reasonably lightweight as well, because it's not all that big, so it's... As far as the first entry into this whole market goes, it's a really nice piece of kit, and I'm going to try not to drop it.
Cool. Yeah, we're going to use that for a test jig at some point.
Yeah, it's destiny, basically. It's sitting down in the bot lab at some point in time. It will become the screen for a test jig.
So that was all right. Had its quirks. A few too many weird cables needed, but otherwise, it was there first. It was useful first. And had the right idea for a new Pi community. So then the kind of next Pi-in-a-box type stuff was really the Carno kit, which you've got kind of your Carno kit, which is, what is it now, about 120 quid including VAT?
I haven't been following it.
Somewhere
that
in that ballpark.
Right.
And for that you don't get a screen, but then last year they released their screen kit, which has a reasonably nice little screen. It's got some good plastic, good nice driver board enclosed there, some good moulding. We didn't like the Velcro they use for the keypad, but it's small potatoes.
Yeah.
And it has the nice stand, so it can go like that, or you can have it in desktop orientation like that. And not do that, because
it's not a touchscreen.
Yeah, it's not a touchscreen, but again, that was about another 100 quid, wasn't it?
It's expensive, but it is.
But
once,
that's the Pi and everything
together.
It's
a nice
literally everything.
And the keyboard does slot in there. It gives you a nice little self-contained thing. You can just shove it in the back and away you go.
Yeah, it needs to be a fairly big bag, but it would survive a journey because that's...
Yeah, that will survive a journey.
So, yeah, fairly portable. I love that the keyboard fits in there somehow.
So designed.
Yeah.
So very designed.
Hmm.
And then you just whoop your keyboard out and away you go.
Yeah. And they had some good learning content and things, didn't they, on the desktop?
They did.
Yeah. And they tailored that experience down to some
they
good
graphic
design.
They are one of the few people who've taken the Pi and actually nailed turning it into something that's completely coherent and experienced and everything's
that
nice
Apple-like.
And sane. Yeah, Apple-like is a good way to put it.
Yeah.
Done a very good job of that. And Sandy's been using that screen on my phone.
Yeah, yeah.
For
ages.
Yeah,
it's a good little display. Yeah.
Yeah. And we're very happy to have here today, thanks to the folks at PyTop. They sent us, it feels a bit wrong not to have the seed, because we quite like the seed.
It's so green. I love the green. It's so green.
It's so green.
One in green and one in pink.
Will we do that first then, before we do the...
Yeah, we'll move way across, because we're going to spend some time in the lab dock and just kind of rip it shreds.
Yeah. Will we get the box for the PyTop?
Oh, the PyTop, yeah.
Yeah, the box is for
the boxes. So we've got the big white box.
Yeah, beautiful.
It's lovely. It's really nice. So it's got this really nice sleeve on it that tells you some of the features of it.
It's a little bit of low contrast to see.
So it says...
there is some text on there.
Show some detail.
Yeah, it says
close up.
14-inch HD screen.
Cool. Just coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Try and get it.
Yeah, we're overexposed today.
It's still very overexposed.
There we go.
There we go.
Adjustable viewing angle, modular components, and then it's basically the same on the front. And then you slide it out of the sleeve.
This is like the biggest cardboard sleeve setup I've ever seen, but they pulled it off so well. And even the box and the way it has been green, kind of.
I don't know if you can see this on camera. If we angle it, no, you can't see it.
Yeah, you see on the close-up.
Exposed.
Oh, the embossed logo.
It's got an embossed logo on it.
Just stroke it gently to give the impression of it being quality premium.
Yeah, it's a nice little touch, the embossed logo. And then actually inside, we've obviously taken out already, so this is basically just an empty box, but it's got a nice moulded cardboard tray in it where all the bits slot in. It's got the box for the Raspberry Pi 3. It's got a thing called the Proto Board, which we'll see in a minute or two.
They've got the little boxes as well for all these, which is great.
And the speaker box is actually like a mini version of the big box.
Cracked speaker open on the...
It's got the...
The sleeve.
So it's got the little sleeve on it.
I love it, it's like a matchbox.
And then it's got the embossed logo. And then you open it up and it's got the speaker inside it.
Yeah.
As far as unboxing experience goes, I think they get top marks.
Yeah.
Absolute top marks.
That's all very nice.
That's super
They have
shiny.
A little card that's got the GPIO pins all labelled and coloured as well. So that's handy.
Cool. It fits over the GPIO.
What it is in the corner there is a pin out. Dot XYZ.
This was $99 on the Kickstarter.
That's
and for that,
fantastic value.
You don't get the Pi in that, but that's okay.
Still, that is...
You get the screen.
For something that's that mint out of the box, you're not going to feel disappointed.
I think on the RS now, you pay about £120, including VAT.
Yeah.
So it's still not that bad. Because you do get, if we...
For that primo out-of-the-box experience and for that kind of Christmas present sort of tier, I think that's really nice.
Cool.
It's very, very nice. And I can't get over that green. I like vibrant green.
Yeah, so the whole thing is basically just like one injection moulded plastic enclosure.
Basically the iMac of Raspberry Pi, isn't it?
It's got a metal, I don't know what you'd call it, kickstand, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
That is really, I think the key thing about this is really stiff. So if you set it to a particular angle and then sit it down, it's not going to move.
It's going to stay there.
It's really solid.
Nice and adjustable. Cool.
So that's nice. And then actually when you put it together, you basically slide out this Perspex piece on the front.
Reveal all the shiny in it.
And then you're... all of these bits that are in here, it comes with... this is the display driver board.
Yep.
It's also where the power plug's in as well.
Yeah, they're pointing out in chat that this is actually the Seed Pro kit. So that's the one that comes with the speaker and the Proto.
Yeah.
And it's £120, including VAT.
Yeah.
So, that explains the kind of price bump. But, they work.
So you've got the display driver board and power management stuff on this.
Hub.
Yeah, the hub. Mm-hmm. The hub. The PyTop hub. That's yep. that's this board. You've got the Raspberry Pi is here, and you've got the HDMI going to the driver board. You've got a cable here that is routing the GPIO to the hub.
And the power, presumably.
Yeah. So it's powered via this hub board through the GPIO.
Yeah.
And then if I just pull this, we've put a unicorn hat in here.
Gently rocking.
Yep. Gently get that off. There we go. So this is the PyTop Proto board. So this just has like a kind of edge pin connector, and it slots into the hub.
It's a very clever system.
All of these are held on by little standoffs that have got magnets on the back.
Wow, that's
and the magnets. Yeah, the magnets stick to the two rails that are there.
So you just have little posts that go through the hat mount.
So you can actually daisy chain something else off the speaker as well, because they've got these little in-out headers set up.
So these are the magnets at the corners here.
What happens
they're
with the
strong
as
well,
on the speaker?
Yeah, they're really, really strong.
Presumably so just shunk.
You just clip it back on like that.
And then perfectly and goes, nice.
Slot it in, it's very nice.
And they've kind of gone similar to the Kano route, haven't they, with the desktop?
Yeah, because the GPIO is going through the hub, it's also broken out on the Proto board, so that means that you can attach hats to it. If we slot the Perspex back in, so we did this. They've got this kind of dashboard for PyTop.
Yeah,
And it has things like it's got a really simple terminal, so basically you just move the mouse down to the bottom left hand corner and the terminal pops up. So that's really easy.
Can we show a bit of the other thing as well before we do that, because there's a couple of things. We've got a preview here of something that I don't think actually gets released until Friday, and it's got these kind of learning resources.
Try and get this on the camera.
So it's got these tutorials, and these are supposed to be kind of a classroom thing where you can have loads of PyTops and see kind of how the students are getting on with the assessments and things.
I'm going to learn things.
Which is actually kind of that step beyond. They're really going for the classrooms here. And with the kickstand, because like Phil was saying, this could go in a rucksack, but with the screen like that, it's not the best thing. So it's definitely aimed at the classroom, I think. Yeah. And it works. The screen's a bit higher.
It's still portable, though. I mean, you could tote this around quite easily.
Yeah.
I mean, actually, that pretty much serves as a handle, doesn't it?
Could do.
Yeah.
I mean, it would fit in a backpack if you had a large backpack.
Screen that you need a cover for the screen.
Yeah.
It's the difference with the Kano, but they're for different purposes, and this is how people are reacting to what people need to do with the Pi.
Yeah.
It's good. It works.
So these tutorials, they're basically Python tutorials.
Okay.
They have a range of different ones that cover things like this one's like Booleans. And then they've got like loops and kind of conditionals and functions and all of that kind of thing. And it's done like Code Academy. So basically you've got the, on the left hand side, you've got the instructions. In the middle, you've got your kind of scratch pad where you write the code. And then on the right hand side, it's got the kind of output of your code.
Okay.
So it's really well done. I went through a couple of the tutorials and they're really good.
Cool. And it's got the universe thing as well, hasn't it?
Yes.
Which
so it's like a
Memorpg type thing.
Yeah,
MMORPG. Yeah. Can we get into that quickly?
Yeah, let's have a look at that.
It's kind of pretty.
I've not had a play with this yet.
Got a Memorpg.
You've got to have a Memorpg these days. It's like the Pocket Chip had the Pico 8 on it.
Yeah.
Just because you've got to have something like that to be marketable.
Yeah.
They are cool things.
Spaceship?
It's a parallax spaceship.
It is a spaceship, yeah. It moves when you...
So it's all very nice.
Are we going to play it, are we?
Yes, we have to.
Briefly, just because Pixels. Everyone loves Pixels.
Select your save file, start a new game. New game name, create.
Oh, there we go.
I'm walking around.
So the camera's at a slightly odd angle, but this is...
I have no idea what I'm doing. Can I shoot people? Can I
you
shoot
wasn't
that guy? La 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 la. Oh, wow, I love the pixels.
Cool.
Where did this come from then? Who's developing the...
I don't know. I think there must be something out there that...
Access everything you found and created items. So I'm on board my spaceship at the moment.
There seems to be a lot of things on Steam that pop up using engines like this. So I think there might be kind of a pixel walk bugger.
It's really well
engine
done,
out
isn't
there.
It?
Yeah. Right, cool. Let's look at
we are
unicorns.
Yeah, let's have a look at the unicorn. So we've we've stuck a unicorn hat inside it.
Tilt the close up. Oh, in fact,
yeah.
Wind it back a bit. Watch this space.
Here we go.
Unicorns coming soon.
There we go.
Check that out.
That's nice. And it also prevents it from completely and totally blinding you with it.
So how did you install that? Was that just...
That was just our one-line installer.
Okay.
Yep.
So connect your Pi to wireless.
Yep. One-line
install.
curl-ss get.pimeroni.com/unicorn hat.
Bash.
Yep.
Super bright when you remove the
cool. John Prove is saying Seed Universe is 100% developed by the PyTOT team.
Okay.
So they've just got talented people. That works, I suppose.
Nice.
Someone was asking about further up about a diffuser for LED hats.
Okay.
We actually sell a diffuser there for the Pi Bows, so you can stick that on the top of a Pi Bow.
I've got a couple of prototypes for a pixel diffuser as well that actually do really nice pixel art on the unicorn hat. The trouble is it takes so long to cut and it's very fiddly. Has a habit of exploding into flame. It's lots of very tightly knit, very close squares that are being cut out of a layer of perspex. But it works. We might finally get something out of that. I'm sure. It looks really nice on here.
Cool.
They also have Chromium browser as well on it.
Brave.
Yeah, I think Chromium is an odd choice because I think Firefox, whatever it's called, I've forgotten the three letters on the end of the Firefox.
Oh. Ice Weasel, no?
It was called Ice Weasel, but now it's called Firefox...
Ice?
Something, not ice, no. And I think that's the way forwards.
Okay.
Chromium, I think, is... I don't know.
It seems to work. I tried YouTube on it, and it seems to work pretty well.
Suffice to say, Epiphany is getting a little bit long in the tooth now. I don't think it's been updated for a while. YouTube is starting to crawl on it a bit, because I think the hacks only work when... it can hook into a certain website. I don't know.
Right. The speaker seems to work really well as well, so I'm not sure exactly how that works. I don't know whether it breaks out the HDMI audio and then routes it to the speaker, or exactly how that's working, but it does work with Unicorn Hat running as well, so that's really nice.
Okay, cool.
We should be able to watch ourselves. Yeah, let's not watch the live feed.
We did this last week, didn't we?
Yeah.
Let's stop me doing it intentionally.
That episode was terrible to watch it.
Oh, no. Yes.
The episode's all right.
No, we recognise that the Amazon Dash Button episode was a bit of a farce.
No, it's still good. I think it was just some things, but given me and John just kind of wandered off to London to hobble up with the parliaments.
The audio's muted.
Yes, that would be a problem.
There we go.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's audio
speaker, that's alright.
So that's Unicorn Hat plus audio, which is a complete nightmare.
Oh, we're up.
Okay, there we go.
Nice.
Yeah. But let's get onto the thing that actually kicked this all off, which was next docs have started to drop, and we got a couple here.
Yeah.
And so everyone from, I think, Jim Darby to Lairs to, is it Winklink?
Yeah.
I've been kind of tearing it apart.
I put in the show notes, they seem to have disappeared. I must have added it after it printed. No, Mike Redrobe, also on Twitter, has been doing some cool stuff with the NextDoc. And basically feeding back about all the stuff that I really want to test but haven't got around to yet.
So basically this is kind of a laptop shell that's in no way a massive clone of the MacBook Air. And they've taken out the computer bit and then rehooked all the ports so you can use them as USB peripherals and HDMI peripherals. And they've left all the stuff in there, so they've left two microphones in, I think.
Yep, two microphones.
The cam.
The web camera, I have used it. I've taken terrible pictures of myself.
Yeah.
The SD card slot. Not only is there an SD card slot in there, but you can boot from it with the Pi Zero's USB boot, allegedly. I haven't tested this myself yet. But this is one of the things Mike Redderob has been feeding back to us on Twitter with.
Right.
And you can also boot from a memory stick plugged into the auxiliary USB port over here. And incidentally, the USB cable to connect the Pi 3 up to the next dock is the same as the one used for the Motorola Actrix.
Plus
an additional cable to gender change it as well.
Yep.
So we've got this horrible double USB cable set up here at the moment, and I'm sure there'll be a cable coming at some point in time that will do this directly if the next dock kind of takes off and gets a bit more traction.
So can we show the...
HDMI is nice and simple because you just need a mini HDMI, isn't it? To full-size HDMI cable, just a regular cable, as short as you can get. And
cool.
There it goes.
Yep. Can we show the connection diagram you got there? Because that looks pretty shiny.
We can, yes. We can.
So is this actually Mike's diagram?
I think it was Mike's diagram. I can't remember. I did steal it from Twitter, and thank you whoever did it on Twitter that I stole it from.
I think somebody was saying on the chat...
It basically said, like, the first thing that first confused me when I hooked this up was I plugged a Pi Zero into the USB port and I went and typed on the keyboard and expected it to work and nothing happened. So I kind of went and read the manual and went, the keyboard and trackpad are in fact Bluetooth. But the webcam, the microphone, the transfer shot and the external USB port all go through the USB connection on the left, which is a full-sized female USB socket that you'd normally expect to be connecting a slave device to, because you're using a full-size cable to micro USB to connect your phone. So it's all a little bit weird when you use the Pi with it, but once you get it up and running, it works incredibly well. And you can actually go into the audio and select... I can't even remember how I did that now. Right-click.
Can we rotate it?
Get the camera in that top corner. Let's unplay. It's a laptop. We don't need the power supply plugged in. Probably safer without it. Put that over there.
I think somebody's saying on chat that they'd like to see IPS in these things. And
yeah,
we found that the viewing angle, I think...
panels are a little bit shallow.
On the Carno, the Pytop Seed, and the NextDock, they're all about the same. It's a fine viewing angle, but it's not got the IPS wide viewing range.
So you can actually select analog audio, which is the output on the Pi, HDMI, which is the speakers on the laptop dock. The speakers are underneath, and you can see them there. Where are we? There, and the other side.
Sorry to interrupt. Someone's asking in the chat how big the screen is. It is...
It is 14-inch.
14-inch. It's the same as the Pi Top, and it's the same resolution. It's 1366 by 768.
So it's the normal 16.
Which is pretty roomy. Yeah. It's like the normal laptop of this size display panel, because it's a laptop of this size. Cool. You can also select the headphone output that is on this side of the dock.
Can we kill the...
No one can see anything.
Can we
close up. Oh, here we go.
And
I have stuck the Pi 3 to the back. It's easier to see that way. Using some of our PiCade standoffs, which are used to mount the driver board to the back of the PiCade LCD, so it just sticks the Pi 3 nicely to the back. It's not exactly the best way to tote it around, because now when you put that in a bag, the Pi 3 is sort of flapping in the breeze, but it works, and it's stuck good. It works completely wirelessly, no power. It is a truly portable solution.
The power, we picked up on that earlier, haven't we? Because it comes with kind of... the finest Chinese power supply stroke unintentional soldering.
Shall we
line.
Unplug the death adapter? This is the name that I'm not sure it was coined by. I'm not sure if it's coined by Big Clive, but he likes to refer to these as the death adapter. It's basically a special little plug socket that defeats all of the safety mechanisms that you're used to in a UK plug. So this plugs in and basically gives you lots and lots of nice, great, big, gaping holes in which to stick screws, screwdrivers, keys,
matchsticks,
whatever you want to electrocute yourself with.
Does it have a metal earth pin as well? That's
it's truly tragic.
Because normally they put a plastic earth pin on it.
If there's no actual earth.
In this case you can use the earth.
You can.
Pretty sure you can plug a UK plug into this.
Yes.
For reasons. It is literally the worst thing ever crafted.
But the thing is, in China, this has the Chinese outputs.
and then you plug a UK plug. Don't they also use UK plug sockets of that type in Hong Kong, I think?
Yeah.
It gets around.
We used to run the place or something.
could you accidentally plug it the other way around?
It's AC, so it's if it's the other way around,
you're getting
the same power, which is then rectified into DC, regardless of the polarity.
Yeah, apparently Wink Link, his PSU, has been, very badly behaved.
It's quite, in not
it's
so many words.
As well.
Yeah.
Basically, we figured this has got bell wire on it, and it's an annoying, not necessarily standard jack connector for a 5-volt jack, so we're just going to snip the bell wire off, connect it to a black official Pi adapter at 2.5 amps, and then we'll get a double length cable by soldering the two together, and it'll also not be explodey.
So yeah, I mean, Nextox, they actually delivered their Kickstarter pretty quickly, didn't they? They delivered, basically, even despite a fire in the factory and things. All in all, they didn't do too bad. Although we're not sure they actually got any plans to carry on with this particular model. I think they might go back to the drawing board a bit and just upgrade. But for the price, it's basically a lot of stuff and it's good play. You just take a picture.
I want to prove that it can be done. Oh, badly.
There you go.
That is the least flattering picture ever taken.
Yeah. So for the $99 it cost, it's a good little toy. You won't want to give it to your grandma.
The one major complaint I have, other than the power adapter, is the trackpad is just awful. I mean, it works a lot of the time, and then sometimes it will just go completely bonkers. So it's kind of usable, but mostly not. But you can fix that with a cheap external mouse, and it's not really a problem. So pack a mouse, and you've got a really rather decent on-the-go laptop. And I could see myself sitting on a train with my other computer cost $35 sticker on the back, and then a correction going, oh wait, no, that was this one.
Is this the one that you opened up?
This is the one that I opened up, but we've got another one still in the box that we're going to do a bit of grand unveiling on, but I'm not sure.
Do we have a screwdriver or something worth opening it?
We can do a bit of
unboxing. We'd see it. Here we go. Here's the box.
We're going to try and unbolt that one again.
It's a box.
You're going to open the box. We kept this box aside. Oh, kill the close-up.
Oh, dear.
Kept this box aside to do an on-the-air opening, actually, and never did it. So let's do it. Ah. Help me. Actually, this is rather less premium than the Pi Top seat. It's just a couple of pieces of low density foam.
But this has got the got the death adapter in it.
Really terrible yellow tape. Nice.
Random bits of pulsarian.
There's your death adapter. And inside you've got your MacBook Pro, I mean your Nextbook. So yeah, they're really nice. They do the trick, and hopefully they'll find some funding, they'll find some way to make these a regular thing and keep knocking them out, because they're, despite the trackpad, which they could probably fix anyway in a later revision, it's a really nice piece of kit.
And yeah, I mean, it is quite sturdy, and it feels solid as well.
Yeah, it's basically a clone of the MacBook. If anyone's seen the bottom of a MacBook, you'll know what I'm talking about. The same screw placement, same feet placements, that same back hinge design, except there's obviously no air vent in this. Just the same look and feel.
It's got a big lump of steel inside it.
Oh yeah, we should open this one up and give people a look, because there's potentially room for a Pi Zero in here if you're brave enough to mount the connections in the right place.
Yeah, I ripped out all my precious cables.
I don't think you're going to get that off there.
Okay.
You can just squeeze together. It should just pop off.
So there's actually a bar of steel.
There is, in fact, a bar of steel. You get a free bar of steel.
Wow.
Aye, 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 aye. Oh, one side off.
You can probably just leave it on, can you not?
I could have, but now I've committed to taking it.
Yay!
Oh, it's still turned on. I'm not sure why. Never mind. It'll turn itself off.
When you short the battery.
When we short the battery out. Yeah. There are a number of screws in this, so bear with us!
Right. So we've you started looking at some of the chips in here. Nico's been looking at
Has been looking at some of the chips. So we managed to identify the Bluetooth one and the HDMI to LVDS chip that's on here, which incidentally also supports VGA, apparently.
Yeah,
somewhere buried deep within here will be some solder points that the enterprising hacker can tap into, but probably not.
Oh, it supports VGA.
Because it would depend on the firmware, I suspect, as well, to respond accordingly to that. And obviously, your phone is not going to have a VGA out, so it's really neither here nor there.
Mm.
So how much did they make in the Kickstarter for this?
I don't even
remember. Was it $300,000, something like that? It wasn't a Kickstarter, it was an Indiegogo, I think. And they didn't make either of their targets. Their first stretch goal was basically to change one of the ports to USB-C, and I'm not really sure why.
Why?
And that was at 500,000, and they missed that. And their second stretch goal at 1 million... was to replace the screen with a higher resolution version, which would have been a nice upgrade, actually.
Yeah.
But getting a panel of that size at high resolution generally means getting one that's double the resolution and probably triple the price or something to that effect. So, we
Michael's criticising my Leatherman. I love my Leatherman. It's one of the best things that I own.
Yeah, it's the tool you have with you.
Leatherman does not sponsor this episode of the Bill Show.
I'd love to have them, though. I love my little Leatherman squirts.
Have you seen all the
really small ones
on Twitter about people accepting sponsorship and not declaring it? And poor PewDiePie basically got all of the fallout from journalists about not declaring his sponsorship. And he was the one who actually had. And just because his name was big and popular, he got all of the shields of it.
Right. Yeah. It happens.
I'm starting to like him a lot. He's very funny. You know? I just love the way he rips everyone else.
You know?
Wait, you've left two screws in, so... Oh, no.
I have loosened them.
Yeah. Wow. Excuse loosener. Oh, yeah, not loosened that one, though, have you?
The mould is actually quite nice.
It's good, it's decent. I mean, this clips in around the outside. You haven't cut
not again.
It, at least you didn't cut yourself this time.
That's all right.
This has got enough screws to weather a few broken plastic
clips.
Yeah, it's
well screwed on.
Yay!
We're done.
The battery looks scary in this thing. It's definitely a bit... cheapo.
Oops.
So that is the top assembly. The metal you can see there is a keyboard tray, which will most likely be a standard part. And then these little things here and here are the speakers, which fire out through the bottom, which is fair enough. The trackpad is this very green looking, most likely off the shelf PCB here, which might explain the fact that it's a little bit ropey. And then the main board is over here. I've got mirror image problems with the LVDS to HDMI or HDMI to LVDS driver chip, and that also has the Bluetooth chip on there. I'm not sure which one it is because I can't see the text on, and that actually connects via a ribbon cable over to the other side of the board with the transflash slot, the analog audio out, and the additional USB connection, which are those little on that edge. And of course most of it is battery, and the weight that isn't battery is this little fellow here.
Wow.
And when I you can't see it. When I first opened it up I went, oh, they put a great big bit of metal in it to make it feel primo, and then someone pointed out no, it's to stop it tipping over backwards when you open the lid. So of course I opened the lid without this great big bit of metal on, and it basically just goes, it's still pretty good. Well, but yeah, it's definitely a bit tippy. So if you were to either cut down or remove part of this metal, then you've got a pretty decent slot for fitting a Pi Zero in there, and there's nothing really for it to interfere with on the other side, so there's definitely capacity for a bit of Pi Zero modding in here.
That's
unfortunately
your job for next week, Phil.
Oh no, the HDMI input is actually soldered directly onto the main board, so it's going to be quite difficult to tap in HDMI signals to there. In fact, I'm pointing at the USB HDMI, that one.
Yeah. So worst case, you can just put it out and then go through the side.
USB will be easy because it's just those four solder points there, but HDMI, just pull it out,
pigtail,
and drill it straight back in.
Yeah.
It'll be way less hassle.
It's mostly battery inside there.
Yeah, it's a 10,000 milliamp hour battery.
Like most laptops.
They always are these days, yeah. Should we do your MacBook now?
Yeah, we can pair
that's
them.
Okay. I have opened my iMac, though.
Right.
I did open that once.
Didn't you need dead pullers to get the front of the screen off?
Yeah, you basically need the Yeah, the little window suction cup things to get the front off because it's all held on with magnets.
Can we just do a bit of a close-up just for...
Just
for the crew.
The Soika tree.
Yeah, just point that camera down.
This is really heavy with that strip of metal in.
Right.
You don't mind it tipping back, or if you don't need the tipping back prevention, you can remove a great deal of metal and make the whole thing lighter.
Just gently drive around it.
Gently drive around. So that's your LVDS driver chip there. Oh, we've got a pencil. I can't remember which one Nika said the
pencil.
Bluetooth chip was. I think it might be that one there. I'm not 100% sure. And
I'm generally running my safety drill for what happens when you short something and the battery blows up. How do I get this over
as quickly as possible? It's all right. This is a coloured pencil. It's not lead. So.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
Fine.
Now we've got the little cable tapped off here, which runs to the two microphones, which are there and there. One of them's up here somewhere. One of them's the other end. Obviously, the camera is in the lid, and I did try and remove the plastic around the lid to get at the screen assembly, but unfortunately, a magnet jumped out of its place.
So it
started having a fight with the screen.
Is that the display cable?
That is the display cable, yeah. It's these very, very fine cables that run into a little kind of tightly bunched together set to run through the hinge. So
yeah, they really are fine.
They're always a bit touch and go, though.
Wow.
Absolutely tiny.
And this pointing out that you should replace the trackpad with a Skywriter.
Skywriter trackpad driver.
Because then you'd have room for the Pi Zero.
It's the trackpad there. And then the speaker, one of the speakers.
Fair, the trackpad is so useless that you could probably replace it with anything you wanted and it would be an improvement. Sorry, guys. It is.
Wow.
So it's the cable, is the camera.
Yeah, we'll run through
that cable, same
screen connection cable. There's a lot of stuff going on in that one cable, which is usually the point of failure for things like this. As you move the hinge back and forth, you slowly wear out your screen connection cable.
Mike is asking why there's two mics.
There are two microphones because the original product had two microphones.
But it's normally for noise reduction, isn't it?
Yeah.
It could well be for noise reduction, yeah, but. Or maybe stereo sound, perhaps? Stereo microphones?
Yeah.
In stereo where available, but it makes sense for them if the microphone holes are there to actually support those features, and they seem to have gone to pains to support basically everything regardless of how useful it may or may not be. So it's cool.
Is that just a foam pad there?
Yeah, it's to keep the board wedged up against everything inside, I guess. Well, I'll contact the shielding.
Yeah, it must be ground tone,
connecting the shielding to ground.
Weird.
So it's not bad.
Very nice piece of kit, and I sincerely hope they manage to secure some funding and churn out some more of these. Maybe a bit smaller and move everything to the front edge and drop the metal bar because that's a little heavy. We can make it lighter and smaller and sexier and add a mounting point for a pie on it then.
Yeah.
Bring it on.
Right.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Oh, they've still got the little sticky bits on the back of the speakers. Excellent.
Someone's asking if you could fit a Pi 3 in there.
If you took all the ports off the Pi 3, or if you cut out a portion of the laptop for the ports to hang out,
replace the trackpad with a Pi 3,
or replace the
trackpad. You know, like a V8 where they have the engine, they have the kind of the cams coming out, carburetors.
Or maybe melt the Pi 3 bits out of the bottom, perhaps.
Chop the battery down the middle, and then stick the Pi 3 in the gap.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on, get your knife. Let's give it a go. Actually, you can see the imprint of the two cells in the battery, so you probably could safely chop it down the middle without it exploding, but let's not go there.
Yeah, another week when we've got a fire bucket.
Bucket full of sand. We've got a sandbag to dump on it. But
yeah,
there we have it. It's nice.
Mm.
What's the price? Did we mention the price?
I don't know, because again, it was Indiegogo, so I think it was like $99 for the early birds. Or
for anyone who managed to snag one on Indiegogo, I think they got a really good deal, and they should be pretty pleased.
Maybe there's a bit more. Somebody on chat will correct us. Anyway, yeah, it felt like a lot of fun for the price, especially since it turned up, and they were good about like factory fire photos and things.
Yeah.
They were completely upfront and just like, yeah, we're going to do this, because we can. And yeah, so all power to them. Right, so I think that covers it off. Thanks to everyone who sent stuff in. Thanks to Seed, who in no way sponsored us for this content. We just said, hey, we can't really do this roundup without mentioning it, and we quite like the Seed.
It's nice.
As that kind of classroom solution. So they were kind enough to send us their latest working OS and the thing to show off. So thanks to everyone there. And
can
Ken
they
Lemon.
Have an OS?
Hmm? An OS? Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay, where's Peter Blacksock? Quietly.
Do we have a tumblebeat animation that we can?
Yeah,
sound
yeah,
effects.
We need that one.
Yeah. So we've got a little Vormilo switch tester here for reasons, and we've now got that plugged into the cameras. So we just have a little thing where we can just like put the test card up.
Absolutely brilliant.
Or fade to black, and yeah, it's worked so well this week. There's been very low error rate on the cameras. Apart from forgetting,
you basically need to learn that and keep your hand on it all times and
it's
learn
like
the
calling.
Key positions of
yeah.
your like
it's
like
one,
pro
two,
World of
two,
Warcraft
one,
gamer
two,
camera
two,
switching.
3, 3, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 1.
Half okay. of our audience have now vomited.
Sorry, guys.
They were with the disco lights earlier. Yeah, yeah, $119. Sorry.
Yeah, yeah. That's pretty good deal.
Cool. Right. Don't forget to like.
Comment
and subscribe,
and we'll see you next week for more
week.
Shenanigans pirate style.
Absolutely sweltering right now.
Yeah,
it's been quite warm.
Yeah,
we gotta cool down.